Hello everyone, this is Luigi Storia. Today we talk about bunkering procedure. Bunkering procedure is a procedure when a ship takes fuel for its own demands. And like you go and you fill your car with gasoline or diesel, something like that. Only it's changed that the quantity it's quite enough bigger than a car, okay? First of all, there is a lot of different kind of grades of fuel that a ship can take. It depends also from charter. As you can see here, this image, from this line is applied diesel, which is small line, and from this line it's supplied heavy fuel oil. Okay, this is a bunker badge. There is also a bunker checklist before bunkering. Every time you need to do this, there is a calculation of quantities, which is before bunkering and after bunkering you calculate. And also, sometimes, and most of the times, there are coming some surveyors, bunker surveyors, to measure the ship's tanks and the bunker barge tanks to dispute any problems between the ship and the barge about the quantities. Okay. First of all, the ships, this bunker ship coming to ship to ship, okay, they tie it with these ropes, okay, forward and aft. After that, coming ship officer here and discuss about the time when we will start, about the communication, in which channel they will be if there is emergency situation. Also, sometimes, and most of the times, they supply some emergency stop button. Also, they say the channel they will be on. This is very important because if any emergency, you need to call them or to stop. Inside your tanks, the quantity to be taken inside must be exactly calculated to not overfill your tanks. And also, all your valves must be prepared, must be opened already from before. Also, manifold valves. Make double checks or triple checks. And also, the rule is to start bunker in slow rates, easy, and slow and low pressures. To first to check the line, as the liquid will flow here, you will check the line. You will send some apprentice or some of ratings to check. Also down in the engine room, there will be some by one engineer and will also be communicated with VHF, and he will be observed that everything and all liquids, all fuels go in proper tank. Also, they will give you the flow rate, the maximum flow rate they can supply. Also, in the manifold, here in this area, there is a pressure gauge and temperature gauge where you can see the maximum pressure they give and the temperature. So, the quantities is calculated, everything, and you already prepare your tanks for bunkering. The volume is proper. You have calculated that is enough space to fill them, okay? And it's better to have more space, about better 150 to 200 cubics to be free, so you will not be nervous, you will be calm on bunkering. Also, everything will go fine, you will not have to worry for something, but you must every time stand by to check and make soundings. Sounding, it means that you drop the measure tape inside and calculate the quantity which you have inside your tanks. It's very nice to calculate like this, because you have exactly the monitor about, and you monitor your tanks properly, not only looking from the control room, because if something's wrong with gauge and it's wrong the indication, after there is a problem. So that's why you need to test your indication system and alarm systems, also gauge. You must be sure about your tanks, what you're loading, and if the measurement is correct, you need to compare your measurement with an indication inside engine control room and cargo control room, CCR. This is very important to have under control every time. Also, the tools which you need to use on deck, it must be made of non-flammable, non-spark materials. This is the correct way of working. You must wear your personal protective equipment, helmet, also gloves. Prepare everything, sample bottles, sample sacks, prepare. And also during the bunkering procedure, you need to take samples. Drops easy by all over the steps of bunkering, you take sample, so you can send this sample to laboratories and they will check the quality of fuel which was supplied on your ship. Okay, it's very important. Also, with laboratories analysis will coming, you can know how to handle your fuel exactly, how to handle properly the storage temperatures, everything. Also, from the bunker ship is supplied material data sheets, which is very important about the storage, the handling, the safety procedures which must be followed to storage and handling these fuels. Okay. As the flow rate increase is easy and achieve the maximum flow rate here, you check your tanks, you have some person standby in manifold, everything is safe, everything is fine, everybody is happy. This is most important. And after finish bunkering, you will take measurements again. This is very important to see the quantity. Also, the bunker balance will measure. If there is some trouble, you can discuss with bunker balance about that. If your quantity is lower than the supply, okay. Or you can write a protest about this bunker, okay. And after that, the good practice of engineers is to blow the lines with air. You close your manifold, they increase the air pressure inside these pipes, these hoses, okay? And after the pressure will increase in your manifold 3 kilos, you open the valve quickly, and all this air which is located here will push the remaining liquid inside your bunker lines and will drop to the tanks. In cold condition, like you see here, it's cold weather, -7, -5 about. There's a good rule to blow your lines with air. And also, if the bunker ship do not have air, it's better to blow with ship's air hose connections. Sometimes you need to make your own connection, because there is not connections special for these air blows, and you need some your patent, some connections with air to blow your line. okay, that is it. And there is some also some small details, but if you make one or three bunkerings, you'll be adjusted already in the situation. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye bye. This is Adventure Story. Bye bye.